again. So last time in my story time with Chris, or whatever I'm calling this series, I talked about the old IBM DOS machine I had back in the 80s. And I say I had it in the 80s, but I actually had it well into the 90s too. I think it was probably like Windows, probably 94 or 95 before I actually got a Windows machine. So my family was a little late on that. It was actually my sister who bought our first Windows machine, although I did have some experience with machines before that. But it was a lot of fun having that old DOS machine. It was very limited. But again, the last video I talked about, you know, experimenting and getting in and not being afraid of the machine. But another part of using computers is being creative with what you've got. And so now I'm going to talk about a little bit of creative things I did with this old DOS machine with the limited tools I had. So as I mentioned, two of the programs that we had on this DOS machine were just a basic word processor. It wasn't like Microsoft Word or anything like that. I don't even know what it was called. It was just a word processor that I would type school reports on. And Printmaster, where you could print up. They had, you know, some pixel art on there that you can create cards and flyers with, but you could also design your own images with big square blocks. So starting with that, the word processor I actually would use, I figured out, I think my dad showed me, I would assume that's the only way I figured out how to do it is my dad showed me at that point, that besides just typing characters, there were certain menus you can get into to print special characters. And some of the characters were like for doing borders around your text, or horizontal line dividers to where you could draw a line or a double line. And so I started using these to actually draw maps of my neighborhood. I would go in there and just draw out what my neighborhood looked like with these little characters that were rounded corners and lines. And I would just create maps of my neighborhood because, again, you know, inspired by like movies where you're watching and they like, and again, this is in the 80s and early 90s where you didn't have Google Maps and stuff, but you would see on movies, they'd be like, you know, bringing up these floor plans of houses and stuff like that. So that's what I was trying to create with this this text editor, this barely a word processor. So that was one thing I did. And then I also had the Printmaster program. I'm pretty sure that's what it was called, which I think still exists in some form today, but obviously not like it was back then. Again, you can go in there and you had pre-existing art and you could also create your own art. So you go in there and it would be very low res and you basically you would draw pixel by pixel. It's kind of like designing an icon nowadays, or actually nowadays you don't even draw icons like that. But when you draw computer icons back in the day, you would basically draw pixel by pixel. Now you just take a PNG or whatever and convert it, or just use the PNG. But you would draw these big blocks. So I would draw out these different things. And again, I started drawing maps of my neighborhood with it. And it's just black and white, not even shades of gray for this. And I draw pictures. Now, at the same time, for Christmas one year, I got an animator. And a lot of people don't remember the animator. I think it was made by the same people who made Etch-A-Sketch. And it was basically an electronic Etch-A-Sketch. We had two. I had one, and my sister had one. And basically, you had knobs like an Etch-A-Sketch, but it was digital. And you would draw, you would move to a certain spot on the screen, press a button, and draw a block. And you do that, and then you can press copy, and it would copy the image over to a new frame, and you can modify it a little bit, and you can go up to like 12 frames. And then you press play, and it cycles through all your frames, and you can adjust the speed by going, you know, faster, faster, slower, slower, and it would just loop through an animation you would create. Well, I bring that up because one of the things that came with was a little piece of transparency that went over that screen, so you could trace stuff out of books or magazines, or draw on it with a dry erase marker, put it over the screen, and then you could trace it electronically square by square. Well, I actually used that same thing. I ended up getting some transparencies like they would use at school that were a little bit larger. I would trace pictures out of comic books, usually Punisher comic books, tape them to my computer screen, and do the same thing in the Printmaster. So I'd create these really cool looking images. They're obviously still very blocky and low res, and again, solid black and white. But then also you could quickly scroll through the files, so you could put all your files in one folder and press up and down arrow to scroll through the previews. So I would again make animations and I'd be able to go, watch this to my friends. I'd go tap, 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 and it would loop through the files and I created animations that way on my computer. So again, very limited with my resources, but I was being as creative as possible with my limited resources. And even today, I still try to get the most out of the systems I have, even though we have fast systems. If you're working on a smaller system or with limited tools, you can still accomplish a lot if you're just creative, which was the point of this story. Is last week I told you, don't be scared of the computer. This time I'm telling you, be as creative as possible. So I do thank you for watching, as always, and I hope that you have a great day.